I lost my father in the first wave of killings. And so I became a refugee when I was barely 1 year old. The community that I knew as I grew up was the community of refugees. We became aware that we were indeed people who had been denied rights. Every day in the life of a refugee is a painful reminder of what it is that you've lost. This is a country that has a very rich culture of being Rwandan, and that has been the case for so many centuries.
The divisions developed during the colonial days and a number of years after colonialism. And this brought in a division in our society.
In the whole period of the 60s, the 70s, the 80s, indeed, massive massacres became a distinguishing characteristic of this country.
People always obey the government, so whatever the government says, they obey, whether good or bad sometimes.
But at no time did we lose hope and simply succumb to the temptation of saying, look, everything is lost, we simply cannot make it.
We've made a number of steps in the area of rebuilding the country since 1994, when that tragedy occurred. And I think in the last 9 years, we have made quite some progress. We can say now the country is stable. The people are happy to be back together and working together to rebuild the country.
Rwanda has been very surprising to me. I was coming into this trip with the expectation of seeing not only great despair, but great poverty. The surprise that I have seen is the pride of the people. The pride of the people is not only in the clothing, their smiles. I've yet to see a bit of trash on anywhere on the land.
My vision for Rwanda is to really have Rwanda stop surviving and start living. It's been too long. This country has suffered long enough.
Rwanda has made tremendous progress since 1994, but its people are extremely poor, and people here live on about $220 a year.
The amount of AIDS and the amount of despair is huge.
One of the problems in the healthcare system is that many of the doctors and nurses were either killed or left the country during the 1994 genocide.
Certainly, healthcare is number one among the priorities in the process of rebuilding our country. We are spending towards 10% of our budget.
I think Rwanda can become the jewel of Africa that all other countries in Africa will look to and say, if it can be done there, we can do it too.
Our vision of Rwanda in the coming, say, 20, 30, 50 years should be a society where people live decently.
As a result of this awfulness that happened 10 years ago, there's an awareness of how valuable life is and the potential for life. So out of all that is going to come something very remarkable.